see Nana at the down qua a kufu ado. And so a day nano the same ever betuja.
I mean, those talking about age have no basis. Make no mistake, Nana will lead MPP even if he is in a wheelchair. The date is 3rd September 2013. Kojo Owusu-Ofori was in the studios of Hello FM, a Kumasi-based radio station, making this famous statement with such utter conviction. Many were those who wondered why Sir John, as he was referred to by all, would make these comments barely 3 days after the Supreme Court handed down its controversial 5-4 verdict in the election petition of 2013. Indeed, it riled a few in the New Patriotic Party, who he believed he had all but declared me as presidential candidate for the party for the 2016 election, 3 clear years ahead of time. Perhaps he had seen something others had not. For me, that statement of 3rd September 2013 reinforced my belief that I could always count on Sir John, affectionately known as such as the only knight in Ghanaian politics, as a true and true Akufo-Addo loyalist, and someone I could call a good friend. And so it proved. Even though he lost his bid to retain his position as General Secretary of the party, he never left my side. He campaigned vigorously for me in the run-up to the 2016 election, on radio, on the campaign platform, in the hinterlands. Sir John was there. His joy knew no bounds when the MPP and I won the elections of 2016 decided. I had the privilege of appointing him as Chief Executive Officer of the Forestry Commission, and his record in office vindicated the choice I made. Like everyone who had the opportunity of knowing him, I received the news of his death with great shock and deep sadness. Indeed, the disbelief and grief expressed by many of the news of his death are testimony to how people in and out of the MPP felt about him. Passionate devotee of the Dankwa Domo Buzia political tradition, outstanding stalwart of the MPP, strong defender of human rights as a lawyer, proud, faithful adherent of the Seventh-day Christian Adventist faith. These were the multifaceted aspects of the career and character of Sir John, which earned him great affection and considerable renown. Energetic, buoyant, jovial, with an exceptional sense of humor, and possessing a limitless store of folk tales and proverbs, he affected positively every person with whom he came into contact. He was truly unforgettable, and our party and government owe him an immense debt for his work and commitment. My wife Rebecca and I extend our deepest condolences to his entire family. Sakra, we know, has lost a valiant son. He will be widely missed. May the good Lord bless him and give him a peaceful place of abode in his bosom until the last day of the resurrection, when we shall all meet again. Amen.